I originally was informed I had prostate cancer in June of 2008. When I first got the news, I thought, well, they made a mistake. It was somebody else, and you know, they got the blood samples mixed up.
Lad is my wife's uncle. We heard that he had prostate cancer. I kept thinking about my dad and what kind of procedure they did to him, and it was totally something you wouldn't even want to talk about.
You know, I was really down in the dumps when I found out initially. Didn't want to talk to anybody. The simple question that, how did it happen to me?
So at that time, my wife went to really getting on me about going to check. I guess it had been a couple of years since I've had the test. I went and found out that I had prostate cancer.
Lad had had prostate cancer and he had had the surgery. And my brother was just diagnosed with prostate cancer and he was scheduled for surgery. My brother kept pushing me to go into a urologist and to be checked out, and which I did. That's when I found out that I actually had the prostate cancer, which was a total surprise. I felt like the doctor needed to probably test it again because I was just flabbergasted that I had it because I had no indications that I did.
In my research, I looked at various doctors around the country, and I decided to have the robotic surgery, and I decided that Dr. Patel was the one that was going to work for me the best. You know, I found Dr. Patel, and I just had a feeling that, you know, he really was into this for quite a while, and I had found out that he did, at that time, around 2,800 surgeries, and I really wanted somebody that did enough surgeries that in case something happened, he's been through this already.
I hate Lad had to go through something like that, but it was a blessing that he had, and he had done all the research he did on Dr. Patel. So that's our next step, was to go to Dr. Patel.
I personally didn't do any research. My wife was on a different story. She was on a computer just about every night, looking at different procedures, different doctors, and from what she could come up with on the computer, Dr. Patel was the man.
You know, I've had root canals that were worse. When I came out and woke up before lunch, and I remember wanting to get up, and the nurse said, "Well, you sure you're ready?" I said, "Sure, I'm ready." And I walked that morning.
You know, I never had any problems with the procedure. Everything went just like it was supposed to go and what I was told it would be like.
Actually, I think the procedure was more effective than I hoped, because I always had these thoughts in the back of your mind about your sexual functions and everything else. But with the therapy that I was given from Dr. Patel, I feel that I recovered better than I originally thought I would.
I feel great. I get colds like everybody else, but everything else is normal.
I'm just as active as I was before. I work. I play racquetball several days a week. So I fish, hunt. So I mean, it hasn't kept me from doing anything.
Now that I went through it, I can look back. It was a really good experience, and I think I got the best guy and picked the best surgery for myself.
I would recommend Dr. Patel to anyone. His staff, the hospital staff, everybody is they've bent over backwards to help you out.
It's kind of unique. The three of us had the prostate surgery within the same family, even though they were through in-laws. It's, everything's back to normal. We come up here and work and have a good time, and everybody's health is good. Our PS readings are just about negligible and no ill effects at all. And everything's back to normal.